Nicole, Rhea, Anais, Alicia, Chloe, Grace, Jessica, Courtney and Bethany. Hello everybody. For those of you who don't know me, and I think that's only Courtney and Bethany who I haven't met yet, my name is Bettina and I'm a dancer, and I really believe that everybody can dance and that any movement can be danced. It doesn't matter how big the movement is, how small the movement is, how dynamic or fast, or how quiet and slow and tiny the movement could be potentially. It's just a matter about how we're thinking about dance and how we present it as dance, I guess. So for today, I'm proposing that we're looking at movement that is gestural, so I'm using my hands and my forearms on the table, specifically on the table. So I know I could do lots of stuff with my hands here, I could do lots of gestures in the air, and we will explore that in a different way. But today, as an extra little challenge, we're gonna focus on the hands, sort of like being almost like glued to the table. Of course they're gonna move, but they are always in contact with the table somehow. Even if they're coming off for a moment to do something, they go straight back down into the table in some fashion. So we can explore movements that are sort of like gliding. So my hands can glide, for example. They glide, or they glide, or they glide to some place, or they shift. And I think shifting and gliding is pretty similar. So maybe just explore what the difference maybe is for you, or how you envisage them to be different. So gliding and shifting. Gliding and shifting, shifting and gliding. We're also gonna look at movements that have a rotation or a circles, that where something has to circle. And for example, now my hands are rotating, my forearms are rotating. So I'm thinking about movement that is sort of like, as if it was if my hand was a piece, an orange, for example, it would sort of like roll off, blah, 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 there. We could also think about circles. So I'm drawing circles with my arms, with my hands. But for example, they're still gliding to draw some circles. I'm also thinking about movements that vibrates, or something that is quite fast and has sort of like a fast quality to it. So we're looking at things that are a little bit faster and a bit more sort of like shimmery. What we also could think about while we're doing this little exploration is that, for example, I can think about my hands doing exactly the same movement. So both hands are doing exactly the same thing. They're doing exactly the same, they're going in the same direction, they're having the same action, they do the same, they are in the same, moving in the same speed or quality as each other. I could think about my hands doing completely different things. So one hand doing something and the other hand is doing something different. So while one hand is doing something, the other hand is doing something very different. And that's a little bit harder to do because you're having almost to split your brain. So you give attention to one hand and the other hand is taking up parts of your other half of the brain. So we're doing two different actions at the same time. And I could also think about my hands doing the same action, but going in different directions or in different timings. So for example, they're going the same direction, but at different times. I could do the same thing, but my hand, one hand is doing a different direction. Yeah? Yes, I think these are the options for today that spring to mind easily. Maybe you think about something completely different that you can introduce in this little exploration for today. And one more thing is maybe we can think about where we're looking. So are we, as dancers, do we look at our actions? Are we following what we're doing? Or do we look somewhere else? These are all options to play with. One last thing is that we can think as we're moving, and especially if our arms get involved a little bit, we can think about what effect does that have on the rest of my body. So I've already talked about the eyes, so sometimes the eyes can really follow and be involved in what the hand is doing. Sometimes maybe the eyes are going a different way and that tells a different story. But we can also think about what the rest of my body is doing. So even though I'm moving the arm, I can decide that my body, the rest of my body, stays nice and still, or I can decide that my body goes with it. And that affects my torso and my head. Yeah? Okay, so let's try with some music. If you get stuck or if you don't know what to do, you can follow me for a little bit and then perhaps something starts to happen for yourself. You can really be as inventive as you like, and there's no wrong movement. It's simply about trying out, having fun, and just seeing what we can come up with. And having fun, that's the most important thing. Okay, so I'm going to put on some nice music. And off we go. Just going to make it a bit louder. today. Thank you very much for following. I shall see you soon again. Bye bye. Have fun.